Hello? Yes.
Of course.
Yes, I'm aware.
Well, that's terrible news. Is he going to be okay? No, I understand. And no chance for a rehearsal. Yes. All right. May I get 3 tickets for today? Yes. All right. All right, yes, thank you.
You get any sleep?
No, I didn't get any sleep, Bruno. Manfred starts with a downbeat rest, and you didn't give me a rehearsal with the orchestra.
I thought you were going home.
No, you told me it was a possibility, Bruno.
Good afternoon. United States Rubber Company again invites you to Carnegie Hall to hear a concert of the New York Philharmonic Symphony Orchestra, of which Arto Radzinski is musical director. Bruno Walter, who was to have conducted this afternoon, is ill, and his place will be taken by the young American-born assistant conductor of the Philharmonic Symphony, Leonard Bernstein.
An historic performance. This performance that was fantastic was broadcast all over the world. And I feel obliged to say that Maestro Bernstein was called this morning at 9:30, and he was told that he would actually conduct here for the first time after many years without rehearsal. But he loves the music. He doesn't need rehearsal. He feels it so much. And after many years that he really wanted this, it has happened, and I'm so proud. Carnegie Hall is so proud of you, and New York is proud of you. Leonard Bernstein.
Well, I'll tell you, fellas, I don't remember a thing after that downbeat rest. I must have blacked out, and then when the audience applauded, I came too.
Listen, don't let this get in the way. I want to roll here, baby. I want to be able to choreograph the last segment with the dancers while I'm in Cincinnati.
Okay, but Jerry, I'm in love with the music. I told you, as soon as I have something that I'm cooking up, I'm going to record it and send it to you.
Oh, this is a new ballet he's composing for you? The one about 3 sailors on leave in New York getting up to no good?
That's the one.
Well, don't argue with him, Jerry. He's a young man to be reckoned with. You can read it right here.
Oh, David,
Bernstein
please.
Shows mastery of score.
David,
youthful
please.
Conductor carries out an exacting program in sudden emergency.
Right next to Hitler's bombing of Poland.
Come on in, it's open.
Sorry, gentlemen.
No, he likes leaving the door open.
Oh, hey,
Isaac, how are you? You know David, and that's Jerry Robbins.
Hello.
Hi, Isaac.
Listen, we've got to get you downstairs. You're an hour late, Lenny.
I'm just working around the score.
Well, I understand. Radzinski's coming in at 11:30 to rehearse. Yes,
okay, well, I'll be down in a second.
Isaac, don't forget your show pony here is a composer.
Thank you. I try hard to stay controlled, but I get carried away. Try to act aloof and cold, but I get carried away.
Carried away, carried away, carried away. You get carried, carried away.
When I go to see a moving picture show and I'm watching actors in a scene, I start to think what's happening is really so. The girl, I must protect her. The villain, don't respect her. I leap to her defense and knock a hole right through the screen.
Carried away.
We get carried.
Just carried away. Yeah.
Knows is how he beat the soprano out of his poor baby sister performing all those operas when we were children. Let that be fair warning to you and to everyone. Hello. I thought you might be here. You've certainly been making the rounds. Have you met the gang? Betty and Adolf, they're just arriving.
Hello.
Ellen, of course, you've run into her at her mother's studio, no doubt.
Hello, Felicia.
Who did I miss? Have I missed anyone?
Just the piano player.
Well, I figured you needed no introduction.
Hello, I'm Lenny.
Hello, Felicia.
Bernstein, like that one.
Montalegre.
Montalegre?
Montalegre Cohn.
Cohen? Montalegre Cohn. Well, that's an interesting marriage of words.
You've got that look, that look, that leaves me weak. You with your eyes across the table technique. You've got that look between the lines. You with your let's get more than friendly designs. I should be brave and say, let's have no more of it. But oh, what's the use when you know I love it. You'll only kill my will before I speak. So turn on that low left hook, that look that leaves me weak. All I do is whine with 'em and spit a cup of wine with 'em. Respectable as can be, yet here's what they say to me. You've got that look that leaves me weak. You with your eyes across the table technique. You've got that look between the lines. You with your let's get more than friendly designs. I should be brave and say, let's have no more of it. But oh, what's the use when you know I love it. You'll only kill my will before I speak. So turn on that low left hook, that look that leaves me weak.
Lovely day, lovely life, happily married, sweet little son, family picture, second to none. It's a wonderful life, up to the kitchen, washing machine, colorful bedroom.
I want to see them.
All the things Maestro Gusevski wants you to give up. All the music you've made.
You do?
Yes.
We can't just leave.
Oh, yes, we can.
It's not serious music, is it?
Well, what does that mean?
Well, it means he thinks I could be the first great American conductor.
Is that what you want?
I want a lot of things.
Leonard Bernstein is a composer, conductor, and pianist. His wife, Felicia Montalegre, is an actress. Both lead full professional lives, but they're seldom apart. Mr. Bernstein is 37 years old, but he has been in the public eye for a dozen years. From the time he substituted for Bruno Walter to conduct the Philharmonic Symphony at the age of 25. Since then, Leonard Bernstein has conducted or played all over the world, and he's written symphonies, ballets, and opera, as well as scores for the Broadway musical Wonderful Town and the motion picture On the Waterfront. Felicia Montalegre came to Broadway and American television from Santiago, Chile. She is one of television's first full-fledged dramatic stars. The Bernsteins, Leonard, Felicia, and their children, Jamie and two-month-old Alexander, live in New York City, near Carnegie Hall and Broadway. They've been here for about 3 years. Good evening, Felicia.
Hello, Ed.
Good evening, Lenny.
How are you, Ed?
Good. Lenny, it's always, for me, rather difficult to classify you professionally, since you do so many things at the same time. What do you consider your primary occupation?
I guess I'd have to say that my primary occupation is musician. Anything that has to do with music is my province, wouldn't you say? Whether it's composing it, or conducting it, or teaching it, or studying it, or playing it. As long as it's music, I like it, and I do it.
Felicia, do you have any trouble keeping up with Lenny's activities?
Well, it gets pretty hard, Ed. Yeah, he's taken on a great many activities. The season promises to be a very hectic one. Among them, he's writing two musical shows. One of them is an adaptation of Romeo and Juliet, that's West Side Story, with Jerry Robbins and Arthur Lawrence and wonderfully talented young lyricist Stevie Zondheim. And then he's doing 4 feature presentations in Omnibus, the CBS television program. And,
you know my schedule better than I do.
Felicia, what about you? Are you engaged in other things besides acting?
Well, it gets pretty hard to do much more than take care of this household. My husband and the children, and acting takes the rest of the time that's left over.
And memorizing my projects.
Well, I can't help that.
Lenny, what's the big difference in the life of composer Bernstein and conductor Bernstein?
Well, I suppose it's a difference. It's a personality difference which occurs between any composer versus any creator versus any performer. Any performer, whether it's Toscanini or Tallulah Bankhead or whoever it is, leads a kind of public life. An extrovert life, if you will. It's an oversimplified word, but something like that. Whereas a creative person sits alone in this gray studio that you see here and writes all by himself and communicates with the world in a very private way and lives a rather grand inner life rather than a grand outer life. And if you carry around both personalities, I suppose that means you become a schizophrenic, and that's the end of it.
Felicia, you must be interested in music, too, aren't you?
Well,
it's... Felicia, do you have any trouble keeping up with Lenny's activities?
Okay, so Sopranos, you're on the hot seat. Take from bar 44, just the end of Make Our Garden Grow, heading to the acapella. And Sopranos, make sure that you make space so that the high notes can soar.
Sweetest love, the fairest dream. Thank you. Beelzebub called for his syllabub in the hotel in hell where Persephone first fell blue as the gendarmerie were the waves of the sea.
Rocking and shocking the barmaid. Like balaclava, the lava came down from the roof and the seas blew wooden gendarmerie.
Took them in charge while Beelzebub roared for his rum. None of them come!
I think the main component of this whole piece is becoming one. Not only the timpani in the back, but also the violins in the first. You have to treat them all as one organism. And if you do that, and you just work from there, and I've got you. So don't worry. Okay? I'm right here, and I'm going to bring you through. Okay? Here we go. William, everybody.
Bar 311, please.
Now that you've made it clear, yes. But you're retarding into the fermata.
Yeah, I'm just still unclear after.
No, it's fine. Everything's together. But what happens afterwards? What are you going to do? Because they don't know. Are you going to bleed out of it? Are you going to drip out of it? What are you going to do?
I'll do this.
Leak out of it. That's what it sounds like.
Fermata.
Bar before.
Bar before?
That's not clear.
No, I didn't feel that. One more time, please. Sorry.
Shall I? Okay, that's very nice. That's very nice, but that's still a bar. So, if I could just show you what I think you want, and then if I'm wrong, you tell me.
Yeah.
So I think you want to do what you want to take the photos. You want to do cut off and an upbeat. Quarters. I think that's what you really mean. Bar before the fermata. What?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
What did I get it? What did I do? Ah, that's what I did. Oh. That's for me or for you? Oh, more. More. That's very good. Very good. Okay. Start back here. Okay, thank you. Be kind to him.
Thank you.
Hello? Yes.
Of course.
Yes, I'm aware.
Well, that's terrible news. Is he going to be okay? No, I understand. And no chance for a rehearsal? Yes? All right. May I get 3 tickets for today? Yes. All right. All right, yes, thank you.
You got it, boy!
You get any sleep?
No, I didn't get any sleep, Bruno. Manfred starts with a downbeat rest, and you didn't give me a rehearsal with the orchestra.
I thought you were going home.
No, you told me it was a possibility, Bruno.
Good afternoon. United States Rubber Company again invites you to Carnegie Hall to hear a concert of the New York Philharmonic Symphony Orchestra, of which Arto Radzinski is musical director. Bruno Walter, who was to have conducted this afternoon, is ill, and his place will be taken by the young American-born assistant conductor of the Philharmonic Symphony, Leonard Bernstein.
Historic performance. This performance that was fantastic was broadcast all over the world. And I feel obliged to say that Maestro Bernstein was called this morning at 9:30, and he was told that he would actually conduct here for the first time after many years without rehearsal. But he loves the music. He doesn't need rehearsal. He feels it so much. And after many years that he really wanted this, it has happened, and I'm so proud. Carnegie Hall is so proud of you, and New York is proud of you. Leonard Bernstein.
Well, I'll tell you, fellas, I don't remember a thing after that downbeat rest. I must have blacked out, and then when the audience applauded, I came too.
Listen, don't let this get in the way. I want to roll here, baby. I want to be able to choreograph the last segment with the dancers while I'm in Cincinnati.
Okay, but Jerry, I'm in love with the music. I told you, as soon as I have something I'm cooking up, I'm going to record it and send it to you.
Oh, this is the new ballet he's composing for you? The one about 3 sailors on leave in New York getting up to no good?
That's the one.
Well, don't argue with him, Jerry. He's a young man to be reckoned with. You can read it right here.
Oh, David,
Bernstein
please.
Shows mastery of score.
David,
youthful
please.
Conductor carries out an exacting program in sudden emergency.
Right next to Hitler's bombing of Poland.
Come on in, it's open.
Sorry, gentlemen.
No, he likes leaving the door open.
Oh,
hey, Isaac, how are you? You know David, and that's Jerry Robbins.
Hello.
Hi, Isaac.
Listen, we've got to get you downstairs. You're an hour late, Lenny.
I'm just working around the score.
Oh, I understand. Radzinski's coming in at 11:30 to rehearse. Yes,
okay, well, I'll be down in a second.
Isaac, don't forget your show pony here is a composer.
Thank you.
I try hard to stay controlled, but I get carried away. Try to act aloof and cold, but I get carried away.
Carried away, carried away, carried away. You get carried away.
When I go to see a moving picture show and I'm watching actors in a scene, I start to think what's happening is really so. The girl, I must protect her. The villain, don't respect her. I leap to her defense and knock a hole right through the screen.
Carried away.
Is how he beat the soprano out of his poor baby sister performing all those operas when we were children. Let that be fair warning to you and to everyone. Hello. I thought you might be here. You've certainly been making the rounds. Have you met the gang? Betty and Adolf, they're just arriving.
Hello. Hello.
Ellen, of course, you've run into her at her mother's studio, no doubt.
Hello, Felicia.
Who did I miss? Have I missed anyone?
Just the piano player.
Well, I figured you needed no introduction.
Hello, I'm Lenny.
Hello, Felicia.
Bernstein, like that one.
Montalegre.
Montalegre?
Montalegre Cohn.
Cohen? Montalegre Cohn. Well, that's an interesting marriage of words.
You've got that look, that look, that leaves me weak. You with your eyes across the table technique. You've got that look between the lines. You with your let's get more than friendly designs. I should be brave and say, let's have no more of it. But oh, what's the use when you know I love it? You'll only kill my will before I speak. So turn on that low left hook, that look that leaves me weak. All I do is whine with 'em and spit a cart of wine with 'em, respectable as can be. Yet here's what they say to me. You've got that look that leaves me weak. You with your eyes across the table technique. You've got that look between the lines. You with your let's get more than friendly designs. I should be brave and say, let's have no more of it. But oh, what's the use when you know I love it? You'll only kill my will before I speak. So turn on that low left hook, that look that leaves me weak.
I want to see them.
See what?
All the things Maestro Gusevsky wants you to give up. All the music you've made.
You do?
Yes.
We can't just leave.
Oh, yes, we can. This up, it's so wonderful.
Oh, it's not serious music, is it?
Well, what does that mean?
Well, it means he thinks I could be the first great American conductor.
Is that what you want?
I want a lot of things.
Leonard Bernstein is a composer, conductor, and pianist. His wife, Felicia Montalegre, is an actress. Both lead full professional lives, but they're seldom apart. Mr. Bernstein is 37 years old, but he has been in the public eye for a dozen years. From the time he substituted for Bruno Walter to conduct the Philharmonic Symphony at the age of 25. Since then, Leonard Bernstein has conducted or played all over the world, and he's written symphonies, ballets and opera, as well as scores for the Broadway musical Wonderful Town and the motion picture On the Waterfront. Felicia Montalegre came to Broadway and American television from Santiago, Chile. She is one of television's first full-fledged dramatic stars. The Bernsteins, Leonard, Felicia, and their children, Jamie and two-month-old Alexander, live in New York City, near Carnegie Hall and Broadway. They've been here for about 3 years. Good evening, Felicia.
Hello, Ed.
Good evening, Lenny.
How are you, Ed?
Good. Lenny, it's always, for me, rather difficult to classify you professionally, since you do so many things at the same time. What do you consider your primary occupation?
I guess I'd have to say that my primary occupation is musician. Anything that has to do with music is my province, wouldn't you say? Whether it's composing it, or conducting it, or teaching it, or studying it, or playing it. As long as it's music, I like it, and I do it.
Felicia, do you have any trouble keeping up with Lenny's activities?
Well, it gets pretty hard, Ed. Yeah, he's taken on a great many activities. The season promises to be a very hectic one.
Among them, he's writing two musical shows. One of them is an adaptation of Romeo and Juliet, that's West Side Story, with Jerry Robbins and Arthur Lawrence and wonderfully talented young lyricist Stevie Zondheim. And then he's doing 4 feature presentations in Omnibus, the CBS television program. And,
You know my schedule better than I do.
Felicia, what about you? Are you engaged in other things besides acting?
Well, it gets pretty hard to do much more than take care of this household. My husband and the children, and acting takes the rest of the time that's left over.
And memorizing my projects.
Well, I can't help that.
Lenny, what's the big difference in the life of composer Bernstein and conductor Bernstein?
Well, I suppose it's a difference. It's a personality difference which occurs between any composer versus any creator versus any performer. Any performer, whether it's Toscanini or Tallulah Bankhead or whoever it is, leads a kind of public life. An extrovert life, if you will. It's an oversimplified word, but something like that. Whereas a creative person sits alone in this gray studio that you see here and writes all by himself and communicates with the world in a very private way and lives a rather grand inner life rather than a grand outer life. And if you carry around both personalities, I suppose that means you become a schizophrenic, and that's the end of it.
Felicia, you must be interested in music too, aren't you? Well, it is.
Okay, so Sopranos, you're on the hot seat. Take for Barb 24, just the end to make our garden grow, heading to the acapella. And Sopranos, make sure that you make space so that the high notes can soar.
Sweetest love, the sweetest. Beelzebub called for his syllabub in the hotel in hell where Persephone first fell blue as the gendarmerie were the waves of the sea.
Rocking and shocking the barmaid, like balaclava, the lava came down from the roof and the seas blew wooden gendarmerie.
Took them in charge while Beelzebub roared for his rum. None of them come.
Everybody.
Bar 311, please.
Now that you've made it clear, yes. But you're retarding into the fermata.
Yeah, I'm just still unclear after.
No, it's fine. Everything's together. But what happens afterwards? What are you going to do? Because they don't know. Are you going to bleed out of it? Are you going to drip out of it? What are you going to do?
I'll do this.
Leak out of it. That's what it sounds like.
Fermata.
Bar before.
Bar before.
That's not clear.
I didn't feel that. One more time, please. Sorry.
Shall I? Okay, that's very nice. That's very nice, but that's still a bar. So, if I could just show you what I think you want, and then if I'm wrong, you tell me.
Yeah.
So I think you want to do what you want to take the photos. You want to do cut off and not beat. I think that's what you really mean. Bar before the fermata. One.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
What did I get it? What did I do? Ah, that's what I did. Oh. Now for me or for you? Oh, more. More.
That's very good. Very good. Okay. We start back here. Okay. Thank you. Be kind to him.
Yeah. Thank you.